the title game where it's going to be down the street.
Jim Fisher, you know, maybe one day if I ever.
So just talk about, we also will have the Orange Bowl, you know, President, CEO Dan Sisnulik on as well at around 11:30. So we're going to take a short break here, or we're going
to
from Northern Illinois, you know, after taking the Huskies of Northern Illinois to the Orange Bowl based Jimbo Fisher a couple years ago. So that's what there's, and plus we'll have many, many different people stopping by. So if you're listening to us here on Herb FM on speaker.com, please go to our website. Website is Herb FM Sports Radio at Weebly.com, or you can listen to us on, watch us on Twitter at Herb FM, or Facebook, Herb FM Sports Radio.
Doing great. Thanks for joining us this morning.
How's business?
Business is great. Yeah, how's the travel from here to Charlotte for you?
Good.
Good? Good.
Yeah.
Any issues with the... No? We got Bill Hancock with us, the executive director of the college football playoff, the fourth year of the 12-year contract we have with the college football playoff. So what did you learn through the first 3 years of the college football playoff? What did you learn from every year?
We learned that what we spent 2 years setting up works. The committee protocol works. The fans love the playoff. We're making little tweaks at game week every year. Like we've added, we are reserving charter aircraft for the teams for the championship game. Charters are very difficult to come by these days, and so we pre-reserve them for the teams. So little things like that that can make a better experience for everybody.
Yeah. And talk about the national title game this year is now in Atlanta at the new stadium. Yeah, that beautiful Mercedes-Benz Stadium. Have you taken a tour of it?
Yeah, we've been there many times, probably 8 or 10 times. And during the different phases of construction, it was fun to watch it as things would come together with hard hats and mud in the building. And, man, it's beautiful. It's fantastic. It makes me wonder what stadiums are going to be like in another 10 and 20 years. How can they keep making these stadiums better? I don't know.
Well, let's talk about that. I was looking, you have
a weekend. We never had that before in college football, and because there wasn't one entity to manage things. And we have a concert series with top name acts. We have a wonderful fan festival, a family event. Kids love it. We have a party in Centennial Olympic Park, and another one, a tailgate party outside the stadium before the game. So back in the day, back in the old days, as they say, did was throw out the balls and open the gates and sell tickets and have a game. Well, we discovered about 20 years ago that you can't do that anymore. You have to have activities for fans to do besides the game. And also ways for people in the city who don't have a ticket to be able to touch the event. So that's why we added these activities, and it makes a great festival atmosphere in the city.
You know, I'm curious. We always talk about, you know, being in the business about the panel and choosing the, you know, the teams that get in and so on and so forth. What's the process of choosing a city?
We have a management committee, conference commissioners who manage the event, and they actually choose the host cities. We try to move the event around. Actually, in the first 6 years of sites that have been selected, each of the city that is, and that will generate business opportunities. It might even generate new residents. So an event like ours is terrific for the city.
Just talk about the committee. You guys have new members in the committee this year. So just talk about the new members. Yeah, could you have talk about how many years they're part of the committee and what does it take for them to be on the committee?
Yeah, the committee's terms are 3 years. But to get started, some had 2 years, some 3, and some 4, because we didn't want everybody.
It has to ultimately end up in somewhat of a cohesiveness to pick the college football playoff teams.
We wanted the diversity of opinion, and we have it. And we accomplished that with 5 classifications of members. We have former players, former coaches, former reporters, former university administrators, and then the current athletic directors. And that, all those different backgrounds gives you a nice diversity. The thing they have in common is, of course, knowledge of college football and high integrity. then we make sure we have regional balance, and a lot of people would like to be on this committee. I think it's probably the most prestigious committee in college sports, certainly the most scrutinized.
Absolutely. Well, you know, we talk about college football, and I want to bring up your old Sooners. What do you think about Bob Stoops calling it a day? I mean, one of the greatest college football coaches in my mind, and certainly winning percentage. What did you think about that, and what do we got to do to get your Sooners back in national prominence?
Well, I am a proud Sooner alum, class of 1972. I know neither one of you were born by that time, but Chuck Fairbanks was the coach when I was at Oklahoma, and then he was followed by Barry Switzer. Bob's done a great job. Bob is a high integrity guy who's took great care of his players, but a tough guy, a disciplined, determined guy. One of the many things I really liked about Bob Stoops is he never made excuses.
Right.
Never. And people would try to get him to say, oh, it was the weather, or oh, it was the turnovers, or oh, it was this or that, and Bob never, ever made excuses. Bob's a young man. He's 56, so a lot of good years ahead for him.
Yeah, and it seemed like, you know, I got a chance to talk to him on the teleconference call. It seemed like he knows, you know, he didn't make up any excuses, and he just said, hey, this is what we're going to do. And they play really good, and you'll hear, you know, except for last year with the that running back that, you know, everybody was complaining about, but he still got drafted with the Bengals anyway. So it's like, you know, but he never has an issue with any of his players, and if he does, it's kind of like under the rug and nobody knows about it, you know.
Yeah,
pretty
he
much.
Takes care of things. Yeah. He takes care of things. He expects discipline, and he expects people to do their jobs.
All right, well, Bill Hancock, the director of the College Football Playoff, thank you for your time. I know you're busy making the rounds, but Herb FM Sports Radio certainly appreciates it, as well as your insights, as always.
Thanks very much, guys. Take care.
Thank you.
Thank you.
See ya.
This is Bill Hancock from the College Football Playoff, the executive producer. We're going to take a little break here. When we come back, we'll get our other Mark Baker will be stopping by. We'll be right back.
Thanks again.
My eyes are getting weary. My back is getting tight. I'm sitting here in traffic on the Queensboro Bridge tonight. But I don't care, cause all I wanna do is cash my check and drive right home to you. Cause baby, all my life I will be driving home to you.